Good morning, brothers and sisters. It's so good to be outside today. There's a bit of wind. It's fresh. It's not too hot. We're happy for the little bit of fresh air that we have. I was reading this morning a story that I've read many times, but it just appeared as new as I was reading this morning. It's from the book of Ezra, chapter 7. And let me read from this text, in verse 6 of chapter 7. Ezra was a scholar with a thorough knowledge of the law. Because Ezra had the blessing of the Lord, his God, the emperor gave him everything he asked for. Ezra had devoted his life to studying the law of the Lord, to practicing it, and to teaching. So I was really shocked this morning to see that in this short chapter, many times, the fact that Ezra is a scholar, Ezra is practicing the word, Ezra live and abide by the word of the Lord, and the blessing of the Lord is on him. He receives from the emperor gold, silver, a letter, some instructions, what he has to do, because the emperor says so that the Lord will not be angry against me and my kingdom, and that they will be praying and bringing blessing over the kingdom of the emperor. And the title of the message today, and an encouragement for us, is like I was reading in another text that I will read a bit later, the prayer of a good person. That is the title. Because here you see the prayer and the life and the blessing of Ezra being depicted as a righteous man, a man of God, a man who practices the law and lives by it and teach it to others. And he receives a letter from the emperor and how he's going to spend the money and see that the law will be obeyed over there. This, it reminds me of two short good stories that I watched this week on the internet. One of them is from a Canadian national TV report. A young couple, the man was hospitalized for coronavirus. He almost died. His wife is a Filipina. And they are being interviewed. The man is on his bed recovering. The wife is at home expressing her emotion through this all this whole adventure that they have. And at the end, she says, "May I see something more?" And the interviewer says, "Yes, please go ahead." And she says, "I want to thank God, and I believe in God." And she starts to express her belief in the Lord and national TV in Canada, and how refreshing it has been for me to watch that today. It was a wow story for me. In the midst of all the negative story, one good story is told, and the name of the Lord has been declared. Another wow story of the week was when someone posted the Prime Minister of Australia doing a live talk, cheering up the people in Australia, using the Bible, quoting scriptures, talking about the Lord to the whole nations, praying, repenting, and asking for God's mercy over the nation, all of this on national TV. And that reminds me of Ezra's stories, how God can use godly people to touch other people's life. Whether he uses you through your social media, toward your family or a friend, calling someone, declaring your faith, you don't know how much you can impact the life of someone and bring hope in someone's life in the time of fear and the time of darkness. And the chapter of 7 finish saying, this is Ezra concluding, "Praise the Lord. He has made the emperor willing to honor in this way the temple of the Lord in Jerusalem. By God's grace, I have won the favor of the emperor and all of his powerful officials. The Lord, my God, has given me courage and I have been able to persuade many of the heads of the clans of Israel to return with me. Let's call people to return to the Lord. Let's be instruments of the Lord. It's so wonderful. It's just a beautiful testimony. I praise the Lord. He has made the emperor willing to honor his way. By God's grace, I have won the favor, and he has given me courage, and he has used me and enabled me to bring other people to return. Oh, what a wonderful story. And I want to close with some verses of Psalm 26, because that is where I got this title, The Prayer of a Good Person. Verse 1 to 3, Psalm 26. Declare me innocent, O Lord, because I do what is right and trust you completely. Examine me and test me, Lord. Judge my desires and thoughts. Your constant love is my guide. Your faithfulness always leads me. Oh, praise the Lord. Let it be true to us today. It says, I do what is right and trust you completely. And that is the prayer of the righteous. When we read in James that the prayer of the righteous is effective, it has power, it touches people's life. What is a righteous? Is someone who lives right with the Lord, who practices the word of the Lord and trust in the Lord completely. Praise God. And then he concludes saying, I am safe from all dangers, and the assembly of his people, I praise the Lord. And this morning, among all of you will be watching this video, I praise the Lord and the assemblies of his people. With you, I praise the Lord and I give glory to the Lord. And going through this crisis, the Lord is going to bless us and help enable us to find favor when we need it and to lead others to return to the Lord. Amen. I want to pray today. And on my heart this morning was the thought of praying more specifically for our sisters in Hong Kong and Lighthouse who have been so much isolated for a long time. And oh, I pray that we will be connected. Have you started to reach out? Have you started some groups among yourself, like we do on Wednesday night, and other groups are being formed, to just call some people, says, okay, let's meet tonight on WhatsApp, let's meet tonight on Facebook Messenger, let's do something on Zoom, and let's call a few people of your friends just to enable each other to refresh and talk to one another. I'm also thinking of the parents with your children and these wonderful children that we used to see every Sunday in Sunday school. And for all those of you who are struggling financially because of your loss of jobs or difficulties of any kind, Father, I pray today that you will touch each one of your children's lives. I pray more specifically for our sisters in Lighthouse. This is our local church, Lord. This is where we meet. This is the people that we love and that we support each other. So Lord, I pray for your special mercy and special grace to be upon them. Lord, I pray for the parents and the Sunday school kids, Lord. Oh Lord, bring some hope and some joy in their home, some refreshing and some ideas for the parents and grace and strength. Lord, we pray for those who are struggling financially, who are isolated, who have some sorts of fears about tomorrow. Lord, be their comfort, be their strength, be their anchor, and give them courage, just like Ezra received courage from the Lord. Oh Lord, I thank you and I pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Let us prepare for this Sunday in prayer. God bless you. Have a good week. Follow the announcement on WhatsApp, on Facebook. God bless you.